Good evening and welcome to Canons Ashby. I am Jean-Loup Baudino and I am a volunteer here. I'm looking forward to answering your question about astronomy and astrophysics.
Hello, I'm Lynn, and my question is, if, as I was taught, the visible shape of the moon is created by the Earth's shadow, then it must be on the other side of us from the sun. How is it then that we can see the moon in daylight hours?
Thank you for your question, Lynn. Actually, that's a common misconception. You can see the moon and the phase of the moon because it's illuminated by the sun. And the moon is turning around the Earth. And depending on the angle with the sun, you can see more or less from the moon. Now, there is a point where the Earth is going to block the light from the sun, and that's when you have a lunar eclipse. So a lunar eclipse, it's when the moon, the Earth and the sun are exactly aligned. And at this point, what you are going to see is, first of all, the moon is going to disappear slowly. And when it's exactly aligned, it will be red. And that's because the light from the sun is going through the atmosphere of the Earth and arriving to the moon with the color of the atmosphere of the Earth.
Hello.
Hello.
Our question is, what's beyond the universe?
Thank you for your question, Celeste and Clara. Actually, according to the Oxford English Dictionary, the universe is all space, time and energy. So basically everything is in the universe.
As planet Earth constantly moves, how can navigation by the stars be accurate? The constellations continually move throughout the night. So for instance, the North Star cannot point to the north all night. How is it done?
Thank you, Gordon, for your question. So actually, the North Star is visible all night long, all year long, in the North Hemisphere. And that's because this star is almost exactly aligned with the axis of rotation of the Earth. And you can see it, for example, using a sundial in an historical building. And this is the axis of rotation of the Earth. And if you continue at night, you are going to see Polaris, the North Star. Now, if you want to navigate using the constellation, you can use what is called a nautical almanac. And a nautical almanac is a catalogue with the position of the stars, the planets, the moon, and all around the year. And that was edited historically by the Royal Astronomers at the Observatory of Greenwich.
Hi, my name is Dan, and I would like to ask the astrophysicist how hot stars can get and how small they can be.
So, thank you for your question, Dan. So, to know the temperature of a star, what you are going to look at is their color. If they are blue, they are very hot. If they are red, they are quite cold. And our star is yellow, quite in the middle. So a blue star can be as hot as 30,000 degrees, whereas our sun is only 6,000 degrees. Now, that's for the temperature. If you want the size of the star, well, actually, there is quite an interesting object that is as small as a planet, as small as Jupiter, called the brown dwarf, and they are sometimes called failed stars that can be also as cold as a planet.
My name is Steve. What has been the most significant discovery made by the James Webb Space Telescope so far?
The James Webb Space Telescope has been designed with one of the prime objectives to study the very earliest time, just after the Big Bang, far away in the universe. And one you can see in almost every picture of the James Webb. It's a lot of galaxies, a lot of background galaxies. And there are too many of them. actually, in the earliest time of the universe. There are too many galaxies compared to what we expected to find. And that's very puzzling. And a lot of people are wondering, well, how can we explain that?
My name is Finneas, and I would like to know if you age in a black hole.
Thank you, Finneas, for your question. So, if you are traveling and you are, well, so somewhat finding a way to reach the center of a black hole, for you, you will age normally. But if someone is able to observe your journey from outside, it's going to see you taking an infinite amount of time to reach the black hole. And for the observer, you will never die. You will never age. Well, thank you all for your question. And thank you for your support that helps us take care of places like Canons Ashby.